And welcome to LCN. I'm Zoe.
And I'm Hadley. Veterans Day is this Saturday, November 11th.
Today we'll have a special Veterans Day segment, Thanksgiving Q&A, sports Q&A, and a part two of interviewing new teachers.
We would like to thank all of our veterans by a special segment JP has prepared.
Hey guys, as you know, it's Veterans Day week, and it's custom to thank people who have served in the military for their service. So that's what we're going to do. Let's go. Follow me. Mr. Gillespie, come here. I've something to tell you. Here, I'll hurry up. Thank you for your service, Mr. Gillespie.
I didn't do anything special.
Well, that's okay. You still serve. Thank you.
Yeah, most of my time don't pay for work in a supply.
Well, there you go. That's still service.
I appreciate that.
Yep. Thank you for your service, Mrs. Eiler, to the country.
Thank you.
This way.
Who gave that right to me, and I gladly stand up next to you and defend her.
Hey, Mr. Langer, thank you. I'd just like to come in here and say thank you for your service and everything you've done for this country.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
Let's go this way. Chief. I'd just like to thank you for your service.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Let's go.
From the lakes of Minnesota.
Last and final stop is Miss Norman.
The hills of Tennessee. Across the plains of Texas. From the sea to shining sea.
Miss Norman.
From Detroit.
Thank you for your service to this country.
And New York to
smile.
LA.
All right, that's it for veterans. Thank all veterans for serving this country. Make sure to thank all the veterans that you know.
Happy Veterans Day.
That I'm proud to be an American.
Thanks goes out to all who have served.
We really appreciate you.
Speaking of holidays, Thanksgiving is coming up. Here's Kyra, Zoe, Addison, and Katie with a Thanksgiving Q&A.
Hi, I'm here with
Mrs. Gump.
I'm Mr. Seckman.
And today's question is, would you rather go through a pumpkin patch or a corn maze?
Yes.
A really good corn maze is awesome.
I'd rather go through a pumpkin patch because I already do not have a good sense of direction.
Me neither. I'm Gypsy and I'm here with
Mr. Harold.
What is your favorite type of pie?
Pumpkin.
Hi, I'm Kara, and I'm here with
Mrs. Leibarger.
Your question of the day is, would you rather eat ham or turkey on Thanksgiving?
I would rather eat turkey on Thanksgiving.
Thank you.
I'm Gypsy.
Autumn. I'm Marie.
And today we're going to be asking the question, what is your favorite fall activity?
Soccer.
Hi, I'm Gypsy.
I'm Kenna.
And today we're going to be asking the question, would you rather watch a horror movie or a fall movie?
Definitely a horror movie.
I'm Gypsy.
I'm Sam.
I'm Addie.
And today we're going to be asking, what is your favorite fall snack?
I like spinach dip.
I love pumpkin pie.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Kara, and I'm here with
Samantha.
And Samantha, your question of the day is, what is your favorite fall candy?
Pie candy corn.
My name is Addison, and I'm here with
Marley.
And the question is, what is your favorite horror movie or fall movie?
I love the Scream series.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. I've always loved Thanksgiving food.
Sports have always been my favorite. Landon and Isaac will tell us about our sports events at LCHS.
Landon. And I'm Isaac. And we're here to cover this year's excellent fall season of sports. All of our small fall sports have had an amazing season. Some may even say the best fall season in sports history. So we're going to go ahead and kick it off with golf.
The golf team has had a great year, leading with Scott Underwood placing 11th in states this year.
The girls' soccer team worked hard all season. Brayley Wilson led the team in goals. Aaron Flanagan led the team in assists. They fought hard against highly ranked Herbert Hoover in sectionals.
On to volleyball. The volleyball team has finished 19-14, finishing fifth in the Big Ten. Claire Richard was second in place for serving aces for the Big Ten and ninth for double at the end of their season. Channing Carson and Claire Richards both finished in the top in double A for Diggs in their sectional game against Clay County. They fell short of victory. Volleyball could not advance, but cross country was the turning up this year.
The new coach of cross country, Coach B, and the cross country ran all over the competition all year. Bertie Skinner broke the school record race time for a freshman. At the regional meet, the team placed second. Bertie placed best on the team with sixth place. At states, they placed eighth as a team in double A. Cooper placed 31st, and we had the best placement on the team. Bertie Skinner, Cooper Berghammer, and Maddox Friends were the hard hitters for the cross country team that were named second team all conference. Speaking of hard hits, let's move on to football.
The football team finished the regular season with a record of 6-4. They beat Braxton, Elkins, Lincoln, Buchanan, Philip Barber, and Grafton. Their only losses come from the first seed, North Marion, second seed, Fairmont Senior, third seed, Roane County, and eighth seed, East Fairmont. Braden Carter led the team with over 1,000 rushing yards this season. They were able to make it to the playoffs as the 11th seed, playing Winfield, the 5th seed, November 10th. Come out and support and cheer our Minutemen on the football team for their first playoff game in 10 years. Speaking of cheer, our cheerleaders have been on the sideline cheering on the Minutemen all year, and they have been preparing for have their best year yet.
Cheerleading recently competed at Robert C. Byrd Best of the Nest Cheer Competition on October 28th. They placed first in the division and received second overall, coming only a few points short of beating Jefferson High School for first overall. The cheerleading team recently competed on November 4th at Lincoln High School for the regional championship. Their cheerleaders placed second. Their placement secured them a spot to compete at the state level. States will take place December 9th at Marshall University.
Boys soccer this year finished with a record of 15-4-3, tying the school record for wins. They finished third in the Big Ten. In the section semifinal, they defeated Braxton 10-2. In the sectional final, they defeated Hoover 5-0. In the region, they beat Robert C. Byrd 3-1, advancing to their first state tournament ever. They were the third seed going into the state championship, playing second seed Charleston Catholic. Unfortunately, our boys could not advance due to a 1-0 loss to the defending state champions.
And that concludes our sports for today.
And I'm Landon.
I'm Isaac. Back to the studio.
Thank you. That was sports with Isaac and Landon. I know all staff members, old and new, the Blue and Gray newspaper is up and running again. You can read this and other articles and vote on the polls at bluegray.com.
County High.
I'm Bryn.
I'm Haley.
And we are live on the streets of Minuteman Drive.
Today we're outside pre-evacuation.
This is just a precautionary thing, so we'll be ready for the actual thing.
All right, and now on to actual footage from the drill.
How are you feeling about this evacuation?
I'm excited because you know what we're doing? We are making this place as safe as we can, and we got to practice things sometimes, and that's what we're doing today. It's going to be great.
Thank you.
All right, so how are you feeling about the evacuation?
I'm feeling pretty good. We have a pretty good plan set forward. We T-minus 14 minutes.
Okay.
We're gonna be getting everybody out, hopefully within about 2.5 minutes from the school grounds. And we're going to be heading down 19 South toward the bus garage.
You think it's going to go as planned?
I do.
It's stressful?
No, we don't get stressed over this kind of thing. It's practice makes perfect.
Just a lot of kids.
Yeah, so if we can perfect it over the next year or so, doing these periodically, I think if, God forbid, anything actually happens, we'll be all right.
All right. Well, thank you.
All right. Thank you.
I feel like it was necessary to know where we go at, and I feel way safer that we have a plan.
Yeah, thank you.
How are you feeling about this evacuation?
I have to pee really bad.
Thank you.
to JP and Kellen for a sports Q&A.
Boy, baby, do a leap and make them dance when they come on. Everybody looking for a dance floor to run on.
I'm here with
David Harrifield.
And what's your favorite memory of the soccer season?
I would say beating Buchanan for the first time, 2-0. Tanner Griffith with a goal in the first half and me with a clutch goal in the second half.
All right, thank you.
I'm here with
Gabe Bonnet.
And what's your favorite memory of the football season?
Probably beating Philip Barber in double OT at home in the Mud Bowl.
All right, thank you. I'm here with
Joseph Davison.
And what's your favorite memory of the golf season?
My favorite memory would have to be when Garrett Freeman shot his first 49, got a varsity spot and a golf bag, and then went out and shot 60-some.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I'm here with
Skinner.
And what's your favorite memory of the cross-country season?
Probably making states as a team.
All right, thank you. I'm here with
Channing Carson.
And
Chloe Richards.
What's your guys' favorite memory of the volleyball season?
Last year during sectionals, Carly got in and hit me in the face with the ball during one of the last points of the game.
All right, thank you. I'm here with
Kennedy Willison.
And what's your favorite memory of the soccer season?
When we won a game.
Thank you. Hi, I'm here with
Emma Garrett.
And what are you most looking forward to in the upcoming cheer season?
Probably regionals and winning it, hopefully, and going to state.
All right, thank you.
Volleyball is my favorite sport.
I've always loved soccer. And that's all for the day. I'm Zoe.
And I'm Hadley. Have a good day.